Oh, so she's
hint,
waiting.
Hint.
Is this something you do full time, the two of you?
We did it for our parents, you know, in France, and they really liked it.
Yeah.
And so we tried to create an act, and we did it in schools and colleges. Now, in the meanwhile, people, you know, calling us, and we can come to their, I don't know, parties and stuff and perform.
And what brought you here?
Because we love what we do. We want to share our passion, especially with America.
All right. Well, listen, best of luck, both of you.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
Thank you.
Before we start, we need one thing. Heidi, do you have your handbag with you?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
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 Heidi, please take your handbag and join us on stage. Give Heidi some encouragement. Every time when we perform, people think there must be something in Amelie's ears, like maybe a loudspeaker or something.
So, to verify that there is nothing hidden, check out my ears. If there are like antennas, earphones,
no.
whatever, maybe
little,
my left ear.
A little mold, but that's it. Just kidding.
Please inspect this blindfold as well. I can take this for a second. And just make sure there is nothing inside, nothing hidden, no Wi-Fi, flat screens,
no.
no? Or hold it against your eyes, just for a second. And just to confirm, can you see anything?
Through it?
Yes.
No.
Perfect. Now, come to my right side. And look for one or two objects out of your handbag, and it feels like there's a lot of stuff inside. Whatever you like, and place it on my right hand.
Heidi, you already chose something. It's a small object, you can open it. I quite like this shade, it's lipstick.
Okay, that's correct? Yes.
There is a number on it. I quite like this shade. It's lipstick number 602.
Is that correct?
That is correct.
What?
That's amazing.
Wow.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please look in your pockets, in your handbags, in your wallets, for any objects, any items you brought with you tonight. Make it as difficult as you like. Hold them up. But do not say what it is.
Yes, because that is my job.
Let's start with this.
That feels like a cell phone.
So the color?
It's white.
The brand?
iPhone.
The provider?
There must be AT&T.
AT&T.
Is correct?
Oh, I was right.
What? Thank you so much. A big round of applause for Amelie. Thank you.
You think that was amazing? Did you just see that?
Simon, can you just have a look? There is like no camera in my sleeves.
No.
Nothing on my jacket, in my hair.
No.
All good?
Yeah.
Look again, any objects, any items.
What about this one? You have something in your hand that there is liquid inside. I think these are kind of drops.
No.
And I'm pretty sure those are eye drops.
That is correct?
That is absolutely correct.
If you have a closer look, there is an expiring date on it.
Oh.
There's an expiration date?
Yeah. They expire. They must be May 2017.
That is correct?
Yes.
Yes, it is. Ladies and gentlemen, Amelie.
Good evening, clairvoyance.
Hello.
You were great the first time, and I've never been this amazed by anything. You scare me. Do you believe you have something equal, if not better, tonight?
I believe so.
All right, dazzle me again.
Let's do it. Simon, the last time you said you would love to spend the weekend with us in Vegas, right?
Yes.
And we thought we'll bring Las Vegas to you.
Oh.
We want to show you something we have no influence on. A game of chance.
We need three things we'll find in Vegas. One is a die. One is a deck of playing cards. And we need one last thing.
Money.
Simon, can you take out some money? And just put it on the table. And I will come back to that in a second.
So, Louis, please, check out this blindfold. Have a look if there is anything hidden. So you can't see anything through it?
I can't, no.
Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Can I look at something?
Yes! I'm here for you, Howie.
Okay.
And we'll do a little game with you. Just take the die for a second and roll the die on the table. Oh, number six, you're lucky. You will do it one last time, but this time you will cover it so no one can see what number is on top. Go for it. You're happy?
I'm thrilled.
Thrilled. I will turn around.
Okay.
You will have a look.
Okay. Okay.
You did?
I did.
Reach out your right arm like this to the side.
Howie.
Yes.
I don't think you rolled a very high number. It was not a 4, not a 5, and not a 6. I'm pretty sure how you rolled the 1.
Can we have a look? Yes.
Scared.
Number 1.
That's impossible.
Okay. 1 out of 6. Let's make it a little bit more complex. Let's take the playing cards and Malbi. Shuffle them. Mix them up. Spread out the cards. Make a nice fan. And Louis, you select one card just for you. Keep it a secret. Whatever card you like. And place it face down on my palm. Yes.
Louis, you chose the 5 of hearts.
Yeah.
My God!
Oh my God! Oh my gosh! How did I do that? Oh my God!
Okay. 1 out of 6. 1 out of 52. Let's make it impossible. Let's make it 1 in a million. That's your money on the table, right?
Yeah.
Nothing is set up tonight, that's correct?
Correct.
And I don't want to touch your money at all, but Heidi, you can. Just select one bill and place it on my hand. We will do the impossible. You all know there's a serial number on every bill. To know this exact number, it's more impossible than to win a million in Vegas, but that is what I want to know. Amelie, go for it.
Okay. You like to challenge me tonight. So, but I'll try it. You watch very closely. The first number is an 8, yes? Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
How are they doing this?
Then there's a 9.
Yes.
Yes.
A 7.
Yes.
And a 5.
I can't believe how she can do this.
There's a 3. I sense a 2. No, wait, there's a 3.
Yes.
Yo, she's not from this planet.
The next number must be an 8. That's a 4. And there is a letter. And there must be an A.
Wow!
Is that correct? We are here in Hollywood, and here are so many celebrities. I have some of them, like 200, like Usher, Rihanna, Chris Rock, a lot of different people. And Heidi, I will riffle through the book and just say stop whenever you like.
Okay. Stop.
Here it is. Who is it? Paula Abdul. What a coincidence. Ladies and gentlemen, here she is, Paula Abdul.
Ask us, why do you never play the lottery? We did.
And we won $6.25. It's not so impressive, but Paula, you have the box with you. Can you place it here? I don't want to touch it. Because tonight we are all winners and we just need some random lucky numbers. Can you help,
Paula,
Amelie?
Step over here.
Sure.
We need 6 different numbers between 1 and 50. 50. Paula, you will write them down, and I want you to write down the first number. Maybe it's your lucky number. Just put it in there. Write
okay.
it down.
Wait, first.
Yes, first
okay.
number. Perfect. It is number one.
And Mel B, how many times has Howie refused to shake someone's hand today? A number between 1 and 50.
50.
50, okay. You go for it. Perfect.
Howie, how many times did Mel B say off the chain the whole season?
Oh, that's 47.
47?
Yeah.
Next okay. number, Paula. You're doing amazing.
Heidi, make yes. a guess. How many times does Simon look into the mirror every day?
There's no way to know first.
Yeah, what is it, 1 to 50? 50. I take another 50. Can we take another? Okay, then 49. 49.
That's a lot, Simon. Howie, Simon, last time Howie asked you for a raise. Between 1 and 50, how much would you pay him?
2?
$1 million.
$2? You are not very generous, Simon. But okay. And Paula, your choice, the Powerball. You are writing down the number of the Powerball. It is number 8.
8.
Thank
so we
you
have
very
1,
much.
50, 47, 49, 2, and 8. Step over here, Paula.
Okay.
Because tonight, I think we are all winners. And Amelie and I, we always play the lottery with our lucky numbers. And I have one lottery ticket in this box. Nothing in my hands. I want you to take this box, tip it over, and take out the lottery ticket what's inside. Take the ticket and read the numbers we played.
Okay. 1.
It's number 1.
Yeah. 50?
This one, 50? The next one, just in a row, 1.
She forgetting
glasses. Yes, I need your glasses. 47.
47.
49.
49.
50, we're
50
ahead, but you've
and
1.
8.
This one is a 2.
Oh my God, I need eyeglasses. I need a 2.
Can I help you, Paula?
And the Powerball is number?
The Powerball is number, it's crossed out.
We have
eight.
Number 2 isn't well.
It's 2
well,
and Powerball is number 8. Let's show it to the camera.
It's
These
real.
Are all the numbers. You
real.
Selected.
Oh my God.
You are all winners. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you very much.
Keep this as your lucky charm.
Do I get to take it?
Yes.
Thank you so
and
much.
Wait 1 second, Paula.
Thank you.
Because I have one more thing for you. Take this envelope, hold on to it, and now, ladies and gentlemen, for you, John.
Thorimas!
Yeah. Hey, how you doing?
I'm sure
I tell you what, let's make this easy. Put the envelope here.
I'm putting the envelope
and then
here.
Then put the ticket there.
It's crossed out through the numbers.
Put the ticket down, Paula. Yeah, that was good. I tell you what, Paula, we're going to go like this, and
yeah.
watch. The ticket will disappear. Here's what we're going to do. It's a deck of cards. You got it? Are they all different?
Yes.
Okay, we got all different cards. Just touch one. Anyone you want. Okay, this one. No, keep your finger on it. Perfect. Hold on to it. Show it to the crowd. Show it to the camera. This is awesome. Paula, it's a do as I do. Hold that card in front of you, and I just want you to rip that card in half. So what you're going to have is 2 pieces. You'll have a piece in the left hand and a piece in the right hand. But before you do it, it's more of like a visual thing. Like you just kind of pretend to...
I'm sorry.
Oh.
I did
you know
what?
It's as if we
do.
Took 2 steps forward and we just take 2 steps back.
Wow, that is funny.
Anyways, I tell you what. Hold it like this. And if you would, rip those 2 pieces in half.
Are you sure you want this?
Yeah, I tell you what. Boy, are you guys lucky I came with my magic brown bag today.
Uh-huh.
Paula, drop the pieces inside. Hopefully we're going to make these pieces disappear by shaking the bag. Oh, you know what? Hold on. You should hold on to a corner because it makes the trick better at the end. Look, Jack of Spades, hold on to that. It's a shake, and you go like this. Punch the bag. The pieces completely disappear from inside the bag. Piece is gone.
Oh
Thank
God.
You. And I tell you what. No, you can't look inside the bag. So, before we started, the clairvoyance handed you an envelope.
Yes.
Yeah, do me a favor. I'm going to hold the corner right here.
Okay.
If you would, open that envelope.
No
you had a free choice any card. I thought it'd be cool to take 3 pieces and make 3 pieces disappear and reappear inside that envelope. Boom! Watch this.
Boom.
Take it out. Watch. Hold on. Take it out.
Okay, I'm taking it out.
Yeah. But I thought I'd step the game up. Not only, open it up, not only are those three pieces back in the envelope, but they're back together.
No way.
Hold on, and we're missing one corner. Ladies and gentlemen, right here, that corner fits perfect. I tell you what, no. Ladies and gentlemen, the legend Paula Abdul.
Tonight, we want to show you something very special and different. Ever since Tommy and I got on the show for the first time, people have been coming up to me saying, it must be great to always know what your boyfriend is thinking.
Well, it's not always that great. But tonight, for the first time, you are going to feel how this is. Can we lift up the board? We started very simple. We lived in a small apartment, but we always kept a bowl of jelly beans on the table. Our favorite sweets, because they come in all flavors and colors. Amelie, look away. Simon, pick one jelly bean, anyone.
Thank you.
Give it to me.
Tommy, you're tasting something like... it's sweet. It tastes like berry. It was the purple one.
It is berry. Was it the purple one?
It was.
It was. Heidi, your turn. Take out a different one. Cool. You were going to eat it. Amelie?
Heidi, you taste something different. I sense bubblegum. It was the pink one.
Is that correct? The pink one?
It was. Bubblegum. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Heidi. All
right. Melby, I have the feeling you have a sweet tooth. So I want to take you as many jelly beans as you like.
We'll do that very fair. Amelie, look away. And Melby, take the scoop. Take the glass in the other hand, and you can add scoops into the glass. Half scoops, full scoops, just a few, whatever you like. Howie, how are you tonight?
I'm very good. How are you?
Very good. I'm good. Oh, what would be your dream flavor for a jelly bean?
Oh, Mel B.
Mel B.
it's kind of a spicy chocolate.
A spicy chocolate Mel B. Excellent.
Very sour.
Mel B, you're happy? Or add some more. Yeah. You can add some more if you like.
This is perfect for me.
So there's still some left for us. Thank you so much. Cover the glass with one hand. Put the other hand on top. Amelie, we are ready.
So we all agree that no one knows how many jelly beans are inside this glass, right? But our brain is a curious thing. And somewhere in there, you already know, Melby.
Okay, Amelie, find it.
I want you to look into my eyes, Melby. Your mind seems to be very busy at the moment. Relax. Somewhere I sense the jelly beans already. And I'm sure that you have 22 jelly beans inside this glass.
You can remove the hands. 22, are you sure?
I'm sure. 22 jelly beans.
Okay, that's very fair. Put all the jelly beans on the tray. Push them all to one side. There's nothing left in the glass, right? And count one by one, bean by bean, loud so everyone can hear it.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21,
22 jelly beans. Thank you. These are all yours.
Wait a second. Can we have the board, please? I have to apologize because maybe we were not completely honest with you.
You thought we were reading your minds, but no. Remember, at the beginning, Amelie was standing next to the chalkboard. She said, it will be different tonight. We were not reading your minds. Tonight, we were controlling your thoughts. This board has hanging in full view the entire time. Whatever has been written on it cannot be changed. Amelie, Simon will pick a purple jelly bean.
No.
Heidi will select the bubblegum one. And Mel B will have exactly 22 jelly beans. Oh, P.S.
We hope they'll release spicy chocolate jelly beans very,
very soon.
Soon.
Tonight, we'll bring you back in time to an age before the internet. An age where people went to clairvoyance to get answers.
So let us be your clairvoyance as we explore your most intimate thoughts. No worries, we won't reveal the embarrassing moments, Howie. Yeah. But we will start with you.
Howie, I want you to think of a question you always wanted to ask Simon, but you never did.
Okay.
Now is your chance. Please write down the question and make sure no one else and no camera can see it. Mel B, we're getting a little bit more personal. I'd like you to think of someone, a special person, someone you haven't seen for a very long time, someone we could not know. Focus on their initials and write this stuff down. Thank you. And Heidi, excuse me if we're getting slightly intimate, but I'd like you to remember a kiss you once received and focus on the location. Don't say on your lips. I mean, where you were at the time. And write the location down. When you're done with that, fold the pieces of paper together and hold on to them.
Simon, please stand up and join me.
Oh, again?
Now, imagine you walk down the streets of London together with your family and friends. Close your eyes now. You just achieved a huge life goal and you want to remember this time for the rest of your life. So you look up the Big Ben and the hands on the clock are indicating a very specific time. It's not on the hour, but what time do you see, Simon? Name hour and minute now.
4 minutes past seven.
4 minutes past seven, which is 7:04 in America.
Correct.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Can I go?
No.
Simon, stay here for a second. Because Simon, you imagined yourself walking in London, but you were not alone. We were with you. And we also saw the tower, and we also saw the clock, and indeed, it said 7:04. Amazing, or? Okay, I know you would not believe me. That's why we set the clock before the show started at exactly 7:04. Keep this as a souvenir, and now, judges, stand up, take your folded pieces of paper and join us on stage as we demonstrate how things were done 150 years ago. Come with me. Over there.
Let's gather around the table. Things may get slightly more intense now, but don't worry, you can trust us. Simon, please. Heidi, over here. You just need to keep an open mind and maybe we can go to some very interesting places together.
It's really spooky.
Howie?
Yes?
Hand me your question.
There we go.
I will try to send your question to Amelie.
Howie, your question is very specific. I'm getting it now. You asked for a race.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Is that correct?
Yes. I asked Simon for a race.
Simon, now is your time. You can answer the question or not, as you wish.
No.
No, okay. That was fast. Heidi, give me your paper. This time, I just need to touch it. Oh, give me your right hand.
And give me your left hand, Heidi.
This is weird.
I sense a rush of emotion, such joy. Heidi, you're high up in the air. You're in an airplane. Is that correct?
It is. It's correct.
Thank you.
Thank you. What a beautiful memory. Thank you, Heidi.
Tommy, please take Melby's paper.
Okay.
There is a fire burning deep within you, so I want you to burn her paper, Tommy.
Okay, we can try this. Don't try this at home, but I want you all to look into the candle. Look into the flame of the candle. Or into the flame of the fire. Mel B, you're thinking of someone we could not know. Someone who influenced you when you were younger. Amelie, what is the first initial?
I'm getting an I.
I, is that correct? Focus on the second initial.
The second is a W. No, it's a B.
B, that is correct?
Is that correct?
Yeah.
There is something else I'm getting. Is it possible it's your grandmother you're thinking
yes.
of?
Yes.
I wrote something down before the show started and I put it on a very special place. Tommy, can you help me?
Absolutely. Melvie, open your right hand like this. I don't want to touch the pendant at all, but for the very first time, tell us the name, the first name you're thinking of.
Iris.
Iris, open the pendant on the side. Take out the folded piece of paper, unfold it, and let us all know what's written in there.
my God, oh my God. Iris, you are kidding me.
Iris.
Wow. That's my grandma.
Thank you so much. You can go back to your seat.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mel B.
You can keep the watch, Simon.
Thank you. A little souvenir. Thank you.
That was pretty spooky. The clairvoyance.
America, thank you for voting us to the finals of America's Got Talent.
Hopefully, we have saved the best for last.
You may think our final performance just started a couple seconds ago. No. It began 4 months ago when we, judges, met for the very first time. And from this moment on, everything has been planned. Heidi, you remember the first thing we did? You opened your handbag and Amelie knew exactly what was inside.
Yep.
Well, tonight it will be even more random. Amelie, blindfold yourself. And Heidi, throw this ball into the audience wherever you like.
Okay, good one.
Over there, perfect. Come to the side, sir, come to the side. And take everything out of your pockets. Amelie, look away. Okay, there is one object in my hand. Amelie, what is it?
You can open this object. There is something inside. I sense a wallet.
So great. That is correct?
Yes.
You took something outside. That's a driver's license.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Amelie.
Thank you very much. But now let's try something even more challenging.
Excuse me, what is your name? Your name?
Victor.
Victor, reach out one hand like this, Victor. Now, Victor's birthday.
Victor, hello.
Hi.
You were born quite in the middle of the year. I sense it's May, isn't it?
Yes.
So, okay, the exact day.
It's quite the middle of May. It's May 12th.
Yes.
Really? Thank you so much. It's your applause. Thank you, Amelie.
And Simon. In our second performance, I knew the serial number on your $100 bill.
Yes,
do you remember?
Did. Yes.
Well, there was a reason for that. We needed you to trust us because now we're in the finals. Now we need a little bit more. Take out your wallet.
Yeah.
I'm not kidding. And pass it down the line to Howie.
Really?
Yes, you're lucky today.
Are you serious?
Oh, wow.
I'm very serious, yes.
Last week I asked for a raise. Today I'm going to take
it
myself.
Here it is. There was also a reason for that, Howie. I put it in your pocket. And Mel B, you remember, in our third show, Howie called you a spicy chocolate jelly bean.
Yes.
Tonight you can get him back. What would be your Howie flavor bean? What would it?
A wannabean.
A wannabean?
A wannabean.
A wannabean.
As if you wannabean annoying me all season. Boom.
Okay. Howie, or so to say, wannabe, do you have to pop up, Simon?
Yes.
Stand up and join me on stage. Come with me.
Okay.
And America, for the last 4 months, you've wanted us to make things more challenging. Well, this is going to be the challenge of our lives.
Howie, walk with me. You will get a 360-degree view. There is nothing below the tank.
No.
Nothing above.
Nothing.
No monitors.
Nothing.
No screens. No loudspeakers. No cameras. Stay over here.
Okay.
Because tonight, we are doing something we've never done before and probably will never do it again. Amelie will be surrounded by 250 gallons of water. Amelie, get ready. There is no way of any communication. And Howie, as you said, last week you asked for the pay rise, and that's your chance. You have Simon's wallet, right?
Yes, I do.
Open it and look for any credit card. Take any credit card out of his wallet.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
Hold it so no one can see it.
No one can see it.
And Amelie is getting ready. Now, give me the credit card. Please. Look for the expiration date on it. Come closer, look for the expiration date. Don't say it, only look for it.
All right.
Is the expiration date February 2020?
Yes.
Yes, look for the last four numbers on his card, the last four numbers. Focus on the numbers.
I am.
And for the very first time, tell us, what are the last four numbers on Simon's credit card?
2456.
Step forward and look what she wrote. 2456. Bring this back to Simon. Thank you so much. But, Mel B, we have not forgot about you. Wait for 1 second, Amelie. Do you remember this? This is the pendant you had last week in your hand. And inside was a little piece of paper. It said the name of your grandmother, yeah. Iris, right?
Yeah.
But you missed one very important part. Open your hand like this. Because inside the pendant, engraved into the metal, was a word. And can you tell us what word it is?
Wannabean!
No. Wannabean. Keep this as your souvenir. Thank you so much, America. You've been the thrill of our lives. Thank you.
That is amazing. Hi.
Who are you?
My name is Stephen Brundage.
What are you doing for us today with those bags?
I am going to do Rubik's Cube magic today.
Rubik's Cube magic?
The act that I do, I'm the only person in the world that actually does it.
Yeah. I can't wait to see it.
Awesome. Can I step down towards you?
Why not?
Awesome. Awesome. So we're going to try something with the Rubik's Cube. We're going to mix it up on all six sides. Yep. Now, there's 43 quintillion different ways you can mix it up, so watch that close. Completely mix it up one-handed in the bag as fully as possible. Back to solve. I think you have a guess on how I do that, right? Some people guess there's a second cube in the bag. I will prove the bag is empty. Look, I'll check. Completely empty. Completely empty.
Can I look in it?
Absolutely.
Very good.
Simon, I'm going to do something that's never been done before on TV. Simon, can you actually mix up that Rubik's Cube? Turn it as much as you want. Now, every time you turn it, that's a different one of those 43 quintillion permutations. Simon, whenever you're happy, I will take the cube that you just mixed up and put it back in the bag. Watch that close. Simon's mixed up Rubik's Cube.
Well, that's incredible.
That would be an amazing trick if there was not a second Rubik's Cube in the bag. But that's not the trick. I'm being a cheer, still paying attention. Simon, can you actually cover it up on all six sides? Cover it up? Perfect, like that. Yep. Now, when you think of a solved Rubik's Cube, what do you actually picture?
Solids.
Colors, right? What if I told you that I found a different solution to the Rubik's Cube? Watch close. Right about there. See, the different solution was to match the Rubik's Cube that Simon mixed up 30 seconds ago.
You have.
No.
So if I did match it, you're going to notice we have one side that's going to be a completely perfect match.
Magic is real.
Better than one side, though. That's going to be side number two. That is three. That is four. That is five. That is all six sides, a completely perfect match.
That's amazing.
So I decided, since I didn't use all the judges, I want to come down one more time up close to you and do something amazing. Melby, really important question with the Rubik's Cube. I'm going to start to mix it up. Here's my question. Is that Rubik's Cube still mixed up on all six sides, yes or no?
It looks like it, yes.
I want you to watch close. If I turn the Rubik's Cube one time, that's still going to be mixed up. The cheating happens the moment you throw it straight up in the air. This time twice as hard. We're going to take the Rubik's Cube. It's going to happen right in front of your face. If you actually blink, you're going to miss it. Watch. Completely mixed up from there, less than a millisecond.
How do you do that? That's ridiculous.
Wow.
business making me nervous.
Reba, can you help me out?
Sure.
Awesome. I'm going to step right up here. Reba, hold out your left hand flat for me there. Everyone watch the bottom of the Rubik's Cube closely. Watch that close. Like that. Now, your job is to guard that Rubik's Cube to the very end of the trick. Can you do that?
Yep.
Fantastic. Because nothing's going to happen. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
And we're going to do a card trick real quick during this moment. Heidi, can you actually help me select the card?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Before you select the card, really, really important, I'm going to make sure to give that deck a really good shuffle. So as I go through the cards, any card that you want, it's a completely free choice out of 52. Heidi, when you see a card you want, name it out loud.
Yes.
Anyone you want.
The Six of Diamonds.
The Six of Diamonds. Wait, okay, that card in the middle. Very important question. Have I touched that Rubik's Cube, Reba, since
nope.
I gave it to you?
No, sir.
Everyone watch the Six of Diamonds closely. Watch that close.
Did you turn it up?
Watch that tiny little corner piece.
I'm not moving my eyes off.
You can look at it. I'm going to get that tiny little corner piece to completely disappear from my hand, fly in the air, and land underneath the Rubik's Cube in Reba's hand.
No, you can't do that.
If that corner piece is under, that'd be amazing, right?
Yes.
Reba, lift it up slowly in a loud, clear voice. Is the corner underneath there?
No.
No. That would have been awesome.
It would have been.
I'm going to do one better. That tiny corner piece is going to go inside the Rubik's Cube in your hand. Heidi, can you hold on to the Six of Diamonds?
Uh-huh.
Just like this?
That's impossible.
It is now inside. My hands are empty. I'll take the cube back. I want you to watch really, really closely. I'm going to take off a tiny little piece right there. If I actually break off that tiny little corner piece, everyone's going to notice we're going to have a tiny little Reba, do you mind unfolding that corner piece?
That's crazy. No, no, no.
No, 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 no.
Yes, it is.
No, 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 no.
Oh, my God.
That's ridiculous.
Thank you. As a small child, I could have never imagined that this tiny cube of colors would lead me to the biggest stage on earth and the greatest honor of my life, the semifinals of America's Got Talent. Tonight, we're going to attempt something bigger than I've ever done before. We have a giant tower of Rubik's Cubes right here. We have over 204 Rubik's Cubes stacked up. To give you an idea how many mix-up that is, there's actually more ways to mix up this tower than atoms in the known universe. I want you to watch close. But instead of doing something giant tonight, before we do that, I thought I'd begin where everything all started. Me and a single Rubik's Cube. So I'm going to do down by the judges, Simon. Can you actually help me out?
Yes, no Perfect. Fire.
Here's my question, Simon.
No
is
fire.
That cube still mixed up on those sides? Right?
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. Watch that close. We're going to mix it up just a little bit. From completely mixed up, completely solved.
How do you do that?
Now that's two-handed mixing the cubes.
Oh.
This time we're going to step it up just a bit. We have this cube. You can look at that. We're going to do it one-handed, but twice as hard. One-handed, but behind the back, Howie. You're going to catch it. Both hands out, Howie. Here's my question, Howie. Is that cube still mixed up?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. Watch. One-handed. You better catch it, though. Watch.
I will,
one-handed.
I will.
Behind the back when Howie catches it.
Shut up!
Completely solved.
No. Look at that. Oh, my God. How do you do? That's amazing.
Simon and Howie, hold on to these cubes. Melby and Heidi, I have two cubes for you. Don't mix them up yet.
Okay.
Right now, I need the help of Nick Cannon. Nick Cannon, join me on stage, please.
How did you do that?
Nick, right here we have a deck of celebrity cards. I want you to look close. We have Tom Hanks right here.
Okay.
We have Snoop Dogg.
Snoop Dogg?
Justin Bieber, etc., Emma Stone, Beyonce. You could actually go through. You could see all the cards are completely different in there.
Yes.
Nick, I want you to use your intuition. Whenever you get a feeling,
okay.
I want you to stop on any card that you want. So we're going to deal them down in a pile here. Say the word stop whenever you want.
Okay. Stop.
As many as you want. Perfect.
Stop.
Take that card. Don't look at it yet. Very important. If you stopped on the card earlier, we would have got Lady Gaga.
Nice.
Right? One card later, we also get The Rock. I like him a lot.
Smell
and very,
cooking.
Very important, you can actually see through. All the cards are completely different in the deck.
Yes.
Nick, hold your card close to your heart. Don't look at it yet. Judges, start mixing your cubes. Now, Nick, you're going to tell each judge to stop in any order that you want. And
okay.
Judges, put your cubes down. But wait, If I took your cubes back with my hands, you would accuse me of cube sleight of hand. So I have an anti-cube sleight of hand device right over here. So Nick, get started.
Mel.
Yes.
Stop.
Stop. Perfect, Mel. I'll take it back. Thank you. Next one, Nick.
Simon.
Simon. Stop. Thank you so much, Simon.
Thank you.
Yeah, Heidi. Stop.
Heidi, you can place it down. Perfect. Last but not least, anytime you want.
Howie. Stop it.
Okay. Right there. Perfect. All four cubes mixed up by the judges. My hands have not touched them. Nick, join me back by the tower of cubes for me.
Okay.
Perfect. Nick, we have four holes. We have one, two, three, and four. We're going to choose a cube. Choose a hole. One, two, three, or four.
This one.
Number two, right over there. Yes. We're going to place it right in. We have one, three, and four. Your choice, Nick. Anyone you want.
The bottom one.
The bottom. Which one's the bottom one? There's two. Perfect. Two left. There's one and four. Which one do you want, Nick?
We'll go up top.
Up top, right over there. And last but not least, you left the last cube right down towards the corner near you.
Yes.
Right in there. Nick, you decided everything. You chose which holes. You told the celebrity to stop. You chose which card you wanted. For the first time, Nick, I want you to name your celebrity out loud so everyone could hear you.
Brad Pitt.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Brad Pitt.
Wow. That's pretty impressive. I have no idea how you did that. Stephen Brundage.
First off, thank you, judges, for inviting me back on America's Got Talent. It doesn't mean the world to me. Everyone knows me for doing the Rubik's Cube magic, but I wanted to make my act just a little bit bigger, so I decided to use a giant Rubik's Cube. So, Simon, it is kind of hard to do magic with this, so we're going to save that for later. I want you to guard that with your life.
I got it.
Until the very, very end.
I got it.
And we're going to use Heidi and Mel, you're going to help me out right now. I have this little tiny colored die, Heidi. I want you to take the die, roll it in your hand, roll it on the table, but cover it up so no one in the entire world could see it except for you. So I want you to roll it on the table. Let me know when you could peek out a little color. Do you have a color, Heidi? Do you have a color? Why is everyone laughing? So Melby, also lean in and peek at that same color. Can you do that, Melby? Do you see that same color for me?
Go in there, Mel. Did you see it?
Perfect. You have that color? Perfect. Melby, I want you to name a different color than what you saw on top of that Rubik's Cube. Any color you want.
Name it out loud?
Yeah, out loud so everyone could hear.
Red.
Red. Do you want to change your mind or are you happy with red? That's actually my favorite color as well.
I like red.
Perfect. Melby, I want you to picture all the red stickers disappearing off your Rubik's Cube. Watch close. Check this out. If I actually take out your Rubik's Cube, you're going to notice there's going to be no red colors on that side. There's going to be none on that side, or that side, because the red is hiding right there in the bottom. Now, Heidi, you have a color no one in America knows the color except for you and Melby. Watch close. Picture that color in your mind. Visualize your color. Watch. Think of your color. Check this out. You're going to see none of your color on that side of the cube. None of your color on that side, or that side, because the one color that you're thinking about is going to be the color blue. Show us, Heidi.
He is right. Wow.
Thank you, Mel and Heidi. These are for you to keep right now. And here's the thing. The last two rounds, every judge has helped me out except for Howie. Right, so we're going to have some fun right now, Howie.
Okay.
Absolutely. So right here, I have two special cubes. I want you to grab either one, and your job is to mix it up. Mix up yours. I'm going to mix it mine behind my back.
Behind my back?
Or? No, but in front is fine. Okay. Yeah, just say the word stop. Holy cow, don't break it. Say the word stop anytime you want.
To myself?
To me.
Oh, stop.
Out loud. Stop as well. Holy cow. Look at that. That is amazing. What you see that right there? There's 43 quintillion different ways you can mix it up. Very important. You kind of hid yours up front. I mixed up mine behind my back. You know what the chance of these two cubes matching is?
Not.
One in 43. Just two cubes. Take a look at that. Look, that's going to be a completely perfect match, Howie. Your mixed up cube.
Oh, my God.
But check it out. That is all the sides a perfect match. But wait. Don't clap. Stop. No, I did that before. I did that the first round. Simon, you've been guarding that the entire time, right?
Yes, I have.
Has anyone touched it?
Only me.
Look at how he's mixed up Rubik's Cube. No way.
No way.
Look at that. That is a perfect side on one. That is a second side.
What?
That is a third side. Four, five, all six sides. A perfect match. That is for you to keep, Howie. That's for you. There you go. Thank you, man. You guys are awesome.
Steven Brundage!
Thank you, YouTube. Thank you for watching on air and online. And to subscribe, just click below and comment and like. And just don't touch.